American School of Indian Art. Sri Kanikeshwan is the author and publisher of the templenet.com. Last year, he has also presented an award-winning paper at the Music Academy Conference, Nutuswara Sahityas of Muthuswami Dikshitar. His theatre production, Shanti, A Journey of Peace, was staged in October 2008, and the proceeds donated to Ashavidya Gurukulam, Sedasburg. I now call Sri Kanikeshwan to talk about the CD, and Swamiji will release it.
To Swamiji and to the doyens of Indian classical music. I feel involved in their presence on stage. I'm very proud to share the stage with all of you. I convey my greetings and salutations to the living legends that have breathed life into Indian classical music for the best part of the last 100 years. It is my pleasure and honor to speak before this esteemed galaxy of musicians and guests on a topic that's very close to my heart. I sincerely thank Pujya Swamiji for this opportunity and for his encouragement. I've had many conversations with Pujya Swamiji on the topic of Muthuswami Dikshitar. In one of the conversations, both of us talked about the fact that Muthuswami Dikshitar is nothing short of a rishi, a seer, who was an enlightened person in many aspects of living, many aspects of being, many aspects of Indian culture. Now, it is not at all an overstatement to declare that the music of Muthuswami Dikshitar represents the pinnacle of sophistication in the art of music composition. Indeed, Muthuswami lived some 200 years ago, and his music is a sophisticated encapsulation of Agamic principles, Vedantic ideals, the best in Sanskrit poetry, Stala Puranas and other details, and non-dualistic pluralism and much more, expressed in poetic classical Sanskrit in delectable kritis oozing with raga bhavam, transcending regional barriers and glowing with a pan-Indian appeal. They are not regional at all. Now, there is some relatively unknown aspect of Dikshitar's music. Many of us do not know that one in every 10 of Dikshitar's compositions is what is called a Notaswara Sahitya. A Notaswara Sahitya, what is it? What is a Notaswara Sahitya? See, 200 years ago, when the British came to India, a lot of their music came with them, since they were accompanied by their armies and the bands that played tunes for the marches. They were also accompanied by other Celtic and other bands that played their music, Irish and Scottish tunes that were popular in Europe during that time. Now, Dikshitar heard this music, and what did he do? He wrote lyrics in Sanskrit to some of these compositions, and thus was born a kind of music that is very different from what he had written from the major body of his work. And how many compositions do we have in this genre? Not one, not five, not a dozen, it's about 39 compositions, constituting a unique genre of music referred to as the Notaswara Sahityas, which are neither completely Indian nor completely Western, but they are uniquely both. What do they share in common to the kritis of Dikshitar? Now, they also express the essence of Vedantic ideals, Agamic principles, the Stala Puranas and other Puranas, and non-dualistic pluralism, exactly like the kritis of Dikshitar. I want to illustrate a couple of these examples to you. Here is a tune called This is an Irish tune that made its way to India from from Ireland. It's called Lord MacDonald's Reel. It is a tune that is still popular in today's Celtic repertoire. What we mean by Celtic music is the music of Ireland and Scotland. It is typically played in a folk music setting. You're hearing it played on the flute and on the violin. This is a very popular tune that's playing today. And on top of it are lyrics written about the absolute truth of existence. The absolute reality, Bodham Shiva Shankalpa Vikalpam, Buddha Shuddha Nitya Nirvikalpam, as it comes in Sahajajanachandra Sarasidodayam. But you hear words like Nityam Shuddham Buddham on top of this very playful tune, as you can hear, see here. Okay, here's another example. This is a tune called the Galloping, which is a folk dance tune which is popular in Central Europe, which made its way to England and to the United States. And it's still played in colonial Williamsburg and other places. This is a very playful dance. And what did Dikshita do with it? On top of this, he wrote a beautiful piece of poetry in praise of Kamalamba of Tiruvarur, Kamalasana Mandita Padarje. This is a beautiful composition with each line ending in three claps. There are many more songs like this. There are lullabies, waltzes, and marches, jigs, swings, and so on and so forth. The list is just endless. This is the waltz in praise of Soma Skanda or Ekambarishvara, enshrined in Kanchipuram. And it has its lyrics parallel the lyrics of the song Chintayama in the Raga Bhairavi, which is very heavy kriti. But some of the essence of that song is encapsulated in this very playful waltz. Now, let's listen to one more song which is very special to me. This song is called Para Devate. This is a beautiful composition, and the reason it's special to me is that this is a composition that was played by my grandmother on the veena. We still have a notebook from her that was written, that she had written in a meticulous, painstaking handwriting in the 1920s. It's a yellow parchment that we have at home. So it's like my grandmother used to play it, and now it has come down the generations, and this is my daughter singing it. Altogether, as I said before. Now these compositions represent something very important. And why are they important? Let us step back in time and look at the time period during which Dikshita lived. It was 200 years ago. British colonization was going on. And apart from the face value of what we need in history books, let us look at something very practical. This was a time when Indo-French wars were going on the Indian soil. There were wars of succession, political instability. In the middle of all this, Muthuswami Dikshita was traveling the length and breadth of Tamil Nadu on foot and on bullock cart. He was definitely a part of history. And what did he do when history came at him? He got the music of the colonizers and converted it into something uniquely Indian and beautiful. Very much along the same line, very much the same spirit of Indian culture, which is a striking exhibition of the spirit of inclusivism. The beauty of Indian culture is that if you throw a bouncer at it, it gives you back a sixer. So any cultural influences that have come the way of Indian culture have been absorbed and integrated into its huge knowledge base, out of which only contributions have flowed to the world. I see that a lot of value in these compositions from the standpoint of the following. They are a legacy of Dikshita, they are a window into the world of Dikshita. They are easily learnable by children, hummable by all, and they are representative of India's spirit of inclusivism. And they represent today's globalized world, where a lot of the globe itself is becoming a melting point. So, in conclusion, I just wanted to say a little bit about our experience in working with these compositions. We've been teaching these to children in the United States, and the glow of wonderment that emerges on the face of children when they hear these for the first time is something spectacular. And these compositions are very playful. The children get delighted when they hear them. And when they sing and learn them, the lyrics become part of their being, which is what is the beauty of the whole thing. So which is why we title smile or wonder at itself. We released this recording in the United States in March. It was so cool. So he released it part 2 in October. Then he suggested that we could release it in India as well here, which is why we have it here. And it's my dream and vision that these 39 compositions become part of preschool and kindergarten syllabuses throughout India. So that children get access to the world of classicism in a big way, even when they're very young. After all, nobody can go wrong when you learn the music of Muthuswami Dikshitar when you're 4 years old. I seek the blessings of Muthuswami Ji and all the musical elders on stage so that this vision becomes a reality. Once again, thank you, Muthuswami Ji. Thank you, everyone on stage.
I just want to assure Swamiji that our nursery at least will definitely start off with all these songs. No more Twinkly Twinkly Little Star or Jack and Jill Went Up the Hill. We'll have only Dikshitar songs for the nursery. Thanks to you, Swamiji, for giving me this opportunity.
Pooja Swamiji will now deliver the Anugraha Bhashan.
With the doings of Carnatic music. Sri Raj Mayur and the Chainagi Lalguri, each one.